Roger with Wheel Kinetics in Tucson, Arizona. We're selling this truck on eBay and elsewhere. This is a 2006 Chevy Silverado. It's a half ton crew cab, 4x4. It's an LT. It's got a 6.0 motor, so it's got the big motor in it. It's got a 6-inch lift, Fabtech lift. It has brand new catalytic converters. The catalytic converters and the Fabtech shocks were stolen, so we had to buy 6 Fabtech shocks and brand new high-performance catalytic converters for it, which are installed. It has 84,000 miles, and it's on a clear title. It's a really nice truck. There's not really much to show. I'll just kind of walk you around it. Tires, they're a little chunky, but I would say that they're okay for maybe 3,000 or 4,000 or 5,000 miles. There are the brand new shocks we had to buy that were stolen. It's got, it's black. If it was white, you wouldn't see anything wrong with it, but it's black, so of course you're going to see everything. I see it's really hot, so excuse the water here. There's a little ding right there. Let's see. There's some on the front bumper. There's a little bit. Got some high-speed rock chips. You can see that in my... This is shown in HD, so it should show everything very clearly. Looks like you could probably sand and adjust this bumper a little bit. They always get that little droopy factor when they push people. There's some more new shocks for you. Anyway, there's the passenger front tire. Just a lot of little black things like that. I think if you got, actually, we just sent it to regular detail, but I think if you actually wanted to color sand this thing and get a really good touch-up guy, it would probably work miracles on it, if you wanted to. It's going to be a great value, so it's not going to matter. A little scratch there, door edges, even just some black touch-up paint. It's got this. A little black touch-up paint would be very nice right there. It doesn't have that center cap. But if you were to find the wheel name, you'd probably find that online somewhere. There's the passenger rear tire. There's your bed. It looks like it's missing the bezel around the tailgate handle, which are about $54 because we buy them all the time. I'm not really sure why, but they seem to get stolen on just about every Chevy truck. So if you want to add that to the price, whatever we agree on, we'll put it on for you. It's not a big deal. This is the driver rear tire. That one looks like it's kind of, 30% maybe. Let's see. This looks like paint right here. It looks like road paint that didn't come off in the buffer. That's not a scratch. Let's see. We got some scratches on the back of the cab right there. But really, I mean, when you see these HD pictures, people are like, wow. Every time they see our vehicles in person, they tell us how they look better in person than they did in the videos. And it's because our cameras and our HD stuff picks up things better than the human eye does. So, we try to make sure that you guys see every bit of what we see, if not more. So, there's your under the hood. Okay. There you go. There's your 6.0 Vortex Max motor. Everything is very normal under here. Very straight and very normal. All right. Push the hood down a little bit there. All right, let's see. There's our door panel. The seats are in really good shape. A little bit of something right there. That's not a tear, though. I don't know what that is. This looks in really good shape for considering the miles and there used to be an overhead cluster right there. See that little patch in the headliner? Our repair guy, seat repair, vital guy, put that on there. We don't even know what goes there. It could be just a sunglass holder, or it could be some sort of a computer or lights or something. I don't know. But it's not a necessary item to make anything work or anything like that. So, you know, let's see. 84,433 miles. We're still waiting on a brake booster to come. It's like an $80 part. So we're waiting for that to show up. And when it shows up, we'll put it on. It takes about 2 seconds. It kind of makes the brake pedal a little bit soft, but actually right now it feels fine. And that's about that. Let's see. There's your air. You can hear it blowing really hard. And it's cool, which is good. There's your radio and changer. You got your seats and your heated front seats, dual heated front seats. It's only 103, it feels hotter than that. You got OnStar, you got overdrive, on and off. Let's see, what else you got? You got your volume controls, you've got your AC over, or your cruise control there. Let's see, let's put it into neutral, and we'll put it into four low, and I'll put it into drive, and yeah, that's a lot of torque. That is definitely, and reverse, yep, and it's definitely in four-wheel drive. Go to four high, drive, perfect, and reverse, yep. All right, let's put it into auto four-wheel drive up here, okay. Put it in drive, forward, yes, and backwards, yes, okay, into two wheel, there we go, okay, like I said, they're heated power seats also with memory, I think we need to go down the street real quick and get this over with. I only have a minute and 30 seconds left. It's a 10 minute limit on YouTube, and that. We have a mountain of keys banging around here. We have two remotes and keys everywhere. So that's what you're going to hear flopping around here, which is a good thing to have some keys. All right. And we'll go on to our poorly maintained roads run by the worst city council in the world. And actually, for a 6-inch lift on off-road tires, this thing has a really nice ride on a terrible road. So, that's good. Let's see. I'm going to give it some gas here. You guys can watch the... Anyway, this thing runs great. Drives nice and straight. Could use some tires probably the next 2 or 3 or 4... Probably more like 3,000 to 5,000 miles. Other than that, you know, a tube of touch-up paint and a guy who knows how to color sand can make this thing look really, really, really good. It's going to be very fairly priced. Please check it out. I'm doing a little four-wheeling here. Please check it out and let us know if you have any questions. Thank you.